Alright, so I've been rewatching all the Scream movies recently, and out of all the movies, I still find the first one to be best. Like, there's something about the story and the kills that are just so much better than the later movies. I don't know what it is, but it's like the other movies just don't hit the same. And I was thinking, why don't I make a video about this? So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna talk about why Scream 1 is a masterpiece. Alright, so first off, let's talk about the opening scene. I love how this movie just jumps right into action. I also love that this movie is aware of other scary movies. Like, for instance, Ghostface says,
"You like scary movies?"
Uh-huh.
"What's your favorite scary movie?"
I don't know.
"You have to have a favorite. What comes to mind?"
Halloween. You know, the one with the guy in the white mask who walks around and stalks babysitters?
Yeah.
What's yours?
Guess.
Nightmare on Elm Street.
Is that the one where the guy had knives for fingers?
Yeah, Freddy Krueger.
Like, this is so cool to have a slasher movie that acknowledges other slasher movies. So after this, the girl and Ghostface keep talking, and then Ghostface says,
"So, you got a boyfriend?"
"Why, you want to ask me out on a date?"
"Maybe. Do you have a boyfriend?"
"No."
"You never told me your name."
"Why do you want to know my name?"
"I want to know who I'm looking at."
Like, bro, if I was on the phone with someone and they asked me that, I would be going so fucking fast. But after this, they keep talking for a little bit, then Ghostface makes the girl play a game to save her boyfriend's life. She has to answer questions about other scary movies. Then she gets one question wrong. I don't know why I'm fucking stuttering. She gets one question wrong, which the question's kind of whack. He asks, like, what's the first killer, or who's the killer in Friday the 13th, the original one? And he was talking about the first one, which was the mother of Jason, not actually Jason, that one. Which, I mean, I don't think I would have got that question either. But anyway, Ghostface kills the boyfriend, then the big chase scene starts. I love how clumsy Ghostface is in this movie. Like, I know people don't like that about this, but I think it adds character and shows that he's, like, human unlike the most other killers in these slasher movies. But after the chase scene, one of the coolest slash, like, saddest scene happens in this movie. The girl's parents are going up the stairs of her house, and Ghostface kills the girl pretty close to the parents. Here, I'll show a clip.
Jesus.
This scene is such a cool scene for an opening slasher movie. I know most slasher movies start like with the killing, but this movie just does it different with the phone call and how and like the game to save the boyfriend and stuff. Like, I'm gonna skip a little bit of the movie because I can't really cover everything in this video. But or about the movie, I don't want to spoil the entire movie, but I'm gonna skip a little bit till this main character Sydney, but she's getting a call from Ghostface. The scene only is like 17 minutes into the movie, so it's not even that bad.
Tatum, just get in the car.
Hello, Sydney.
Hi, who is this?
You tell me.
Well, I have no idea.
Scary night, isn't it? With the murders and all, it's like right out of a horror movie or something.
Randy, you gave yourself away. Are you calling from work? Because Tatum's on her way over.
Do you like scary movies, Sydney?
I like that thing you're doing with your voice, Randy. It's sexy.
What's your favorite scary movie?
Oh, come on. You know I don't watch that shit.
Why not? Too scared?
No. No, it's just, what's the point? They're all the same. Some stupid killer stalking some big-breasted girl who can't act, who's always running up the stairs when she should be going out the front door. It's insulting.
I love this whole scene, and how Billy, her boyfriend, just shows up right after and drops the phone. It fits the scene so perfect. After Billy gets arrested, which I don't know if he would actually get arrested in real life if this wasn't a movie. But anyway, I love how this movie just already points a suspect after Sydney talks to the cops. But the main thing I love about the first Scream movie is it's not that goofy, but it's also not too serious. Like, I feel like every other Scream movie after this is, like, Like, it's just like, I don't know. It doesn't know what it wants to be. Like, Scream 2 is also all goofy towards the halfway point. But also the newest movie, Scream 6, is basically all serious and barely any funny parts. I don't really know how to explain it. If you watch the movie, it's really noticeable. I mean, it might be different for me because I watched them back to back, but I don't know. Another thing I want to point out is that they gotta do something new with the Scream franchise. Like, Scream 6 was kind of the right step in direction with New York and everything, but Scream 6 wasn't really that good of a movie. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, I think it's because, like, I'm getting kind of sick of the same plot over and over again. But in every Scream movie, it's like, I don't know. Like, they just need a new plot. Or, like, something new. Just something new.
The reason Scream 1 is so good is because it's a fresh idea. To make it, like, fun at other horror movies and also have a good balanced storyline, horror story, like, built into that.
After I watched Scream 2, it was like, okay, this shit's kind of getting old now. But I feel like most of that is because, like, I watched all the movies in, like, a week back-to-back. Also, I gotta say, Scream 1's flow was just perfect throughout the entire movie. There was no boring part or anything. It was just a good, solid movie the whole way through. Especially every scene with Billy and Sid. The tension between them is so intense. Like, the way Billy always seems agitated and Sidney's always trying to keep a distance from it. It's like, it makes a great pacing for overall movie. But, I mean, every character in this movie, it's like, so well written. I don't know what I'm saying right now, but they are really well written in this movie. But I'm mad tired. That's what I'm talking about, like, this, by the way. But there's the guy who... There's, like... Okay, here, I'm gonna explain the character. There's the guy who knows everything about scary movies. There's another guy who's just plain out intense and, like, insane and intense. And also is really nice to the girl. But then there's the best friend that never leaves your side. And then there's the main character with trauma in the past. Like, everything just clicks so well in this movie. But that's gonna be the whole video. I don't want to spoil the ending for this movie. So if you haven't seen this movie, you definitely should go watch it. Hope everyone has a good day, and bye.
Also, if you don't like it, just subscribe to the watch.